I do not understand what is going on. After I finished training, I headed back here. Then, out of nowhere, Neji and Tenten attacked me.
Compared to my Byakugan and Gentle Fist style, your attacks are nothing. I shall end this quickly.
This is the end of the line for you. Just try and survive an onslaught of my weapons.
Kakashi-sensei! Neji and Tenten are...
It looks like we were a bit too late. The barrier has already been set up around the village.
Ah, I understand now. They just want to test my training.
You idiot! That's not it at all! They're under the influence of the Genjutsu!
Genjutsu?
That's what I said! They even talk to him until you're blue in the face! They won't listen!
Naruto, how do we break this Genjutsu?
What am I, a genius? We just have to fight him! There's nothing else we can do!
Understood. In that case, I will show you just how much I have been training!
Get ready! First round! Begin!
Is. This is obviously a different jutsu than we encountered before.
Well, what do we do?
Well, first off, we have to get to Lady Tsunade.
Believe that Kagura is behind all of this.
Is she really all that powerful?
She was considered to be the most skilled female ninja after Lady Tsunade. She was particularly skilled in the art of Genjutsu.
The way she dealt with her enemies was extremely cold and cruel in nature.
And it looks like she's mastered that forbidden jutsu.
Forbidden jutsu?
When she left the village, she stole a sealed scroll. It was the forbidden jutsu, known as Soul Bane.
What kind of jutsu is that?
It creates an illusion in the victim's mind, causing them to see friend as foe. Friends and allies will turn against each other until there is no one left.
Then why did she set up that barrier?
That's a necessary step for the full jutsu, and it afflicts everyone at once.
She's not getting away with this! I'll see to that!
This has happened once already, in a town discovered by the Elm.
The place was in ruins. Lady Tsunade sent us back in to investigate.
There were signs of barriers, and everyone had turned on each other.
She used those people as test subjects before attacking the Hidden Leaf.
Everyone who was in the village when the barrier was formed was affected.
Then why wasn't Grandma Tsunade affected by it?
I felt that something was strange when I heard the Anbu's report. So I did my homework and set up a reflective barrier around this room.
That's impressive, Lady Tsunade.
So, Pervy Sage, Is there any way to break this jutsu?
Well, we start by defeating the enemies protecting the four barriers. The problem, however, comes after that.
The jutsu won't be completely broken until we defeat Kagura, will it?
That's exactly right. I'm also worried about that man who was with Kagura.
Come on, Pervy Sage! Why are you so scared? Who cares if she's some highfalutin ninja? Let's go get her!
You may be right. Time is of the essence. Who they are doesn't matter. We have to act quickly.
Lady Tsunade, allow the Anbu to determine Kagura's current whereabouts.
See to it, then. Everyone else, defeat the enemies to take down the barriers. Remember, Kagura's genjutsu is powerful enough to affect even Jonin ninja. Don't let down your guard.
Leave it to us, Grandma Tsunade! We'll protect our friends and the Hidden Leaf Village!